Now, a question that is being asked of mariners who go for their oral examinations is how to prepare the vessel's hold for loading cargo such as wheat. Now, this is specially being asked of those mariners who have never sailed on cargo ships or bulk carriers. The reason being that when you are given the certificate of competence, it is assumed that you will be able to go and sail on any type of vessel. That is why surveyors ask people who have never been on cargo ships or bulk carriers about procedures that are normally followed on such ships, because they kind of know that you may not have the practical knowledge, but they want you to have the theoretical knowledge. So I have seen that recently a lot of surveyors have been asking students about preparing the vessel for specifically loading a grain cargo like wheat, and that's why I thought I will make this video today. Now, before I make this, or before I go into the depths of this video, you have to understand that the reason you are specifically asked about grain cargo is because many of these grain cargoes, as a hygroscopic product, they have a natural moisture content within them. That means that during a voyage, due to compaction, vibration, vessel's movement, many a times this moisture content may come up on the surface of the cargo and create problems for the vessel's officers. And that is why excessive questions are being asked about this kind of cargo, because the surveyors want the mariners to be fully knowledgeable about the properties of the cargo and how to prepare the vessel to load such cargoes. So these cereals or these grains, they actually may retain or absorb or release water vapor and excessive amounts of the inherent moisture contained within them, which also sometimes leads to significant self-heating within the cargo, and which further results in the rotting of the cargo. All right, so in today's video, I will specifically be talking about preparing the ship's hold or holds for carrying wheat cargo. So what you can see in the picture here is a cargo hold where there is some flaking paintwork just under the hatch combing, and this can result in a hold failing the grain survey. So if you are not very familiar with such kind of ships, before you load cargo such as grain, a grain surveyor comes on board and inspects the cargo holds. He inspects the vessel, and only if he or she finds the vessel suitable for loading grain, that he gives his approval, and only then the port can start loading grain in such vessels. So therefore, I've shown you an example of where a vessel may fail a grain survey, because you can see there's a lot of flaking paintwork right under the hatch cover. There's a lot of rust as well, and because of this flaking paint cover, because it may fall into the cargo, which may spoil the cargo, a surveyor may fail this ship if this ship proposes to load the grain cargo. So prior to high pressure hold washing, excess cargo residue on the tank top should be should be removed by hand sweeping and lifted out of the holds via the use of a portable mucking winch. A good working relationship with the stevedores at the discharge port may also help to expedite this operation or make it quicker. And make it more efficient. So after all excessive cargo residue has been removed, then the holds can be washed with salt water using a high pressure hold cleaning gun, which is normally available on most of these cargo ships. Ships are also sometimes fitted with fixed hold cleaning equipment under the hatch covers. So a flexible high pressure hose is connected between a flange on the hatch cover and the deck high pressure hold washing line, which makes it easier for the machine to reach different spaces of the cargo hold. Now, all cargo residues washed down will be removed via the eductor system provided in the hold. So, the eductor system is very similar to a cargo bilge system. So, the eductor system is based on the Venturi effect, which leads to higher, a speedier process of bilge discharge. So water that you use for cleaning the cargo hold actually goes and starts getting collected into the cargo hold bilges. Once the bilge is full, the water is then going into the cargo compartment as well, on the tank top of the cargo or the cargo hold. So a faster discharge process of these bilges leads to a faster pumping out of the water that is being used in the cargo hold washing, because that water cannot remain in the cargo hold. It has to be quickly pumped out. It's dirty water, it's mucky, and it's dirty water should not be in the cargo hold. It should be stripped clean. And that is why the adductor system in the cargo hold bilges should be maintained. It should be tested, it should be inspected, because it comes very handy when the cargo holds are being washed. So special attention should be given to cargo residue which is wedged or stuck behind pipe brackets, hold ladders, and on the under deck girders and transversals. Special attention should also be paid to ventilators to ensure that remaining of the previous cargo or remnants of the previous cargo have been removed absolutely clean, and the area is grain clean. It should be absolutely clean of the traces of the previous cargo. Therefore, like I said before, bilge suctions based on adductor systems must be tested both before and after washing, and the results entered in the cargo notebook or in the deck logbook. Now, why should it be tested after it has been used also? Because sometimes some grain may get stuck in the adductor system or in the bilge strainers, which we call, there are strainers in the bilge, which kind of allows the water to pass through, but collects all the solid residue. So that should be cleaned with hand as well. So make sure that once the water has been pumped out of the cargo holds, you go into the cargo hold bilges or ask the crew to go into the cargo hold bilges and clean it, clean the strainer of any dry cargo residue that may have got stuck in the bilge strainer system. The final stage of hold washing is the fresh water rinsing. The fresh water will be pumped into the fire main to prepare holds for wheat. Prior to commencing the fresh water rinse, the fire line is flushed through with the after peak fresh water to remove all traces of salt water. Once the fire main is clear of salt, all deck fire hydrants and anchor washer should be sighted and confirmed that they are closed. On completion of the hold fresh water rinsing, all hatch entrances, hatch trunking, and hand ladders should be hand washed and fresh water rinsed using the fresh water high pressure gun. So the initial washing is with the seawater, and then the second washing is with the fresh water. All right, so that there is no traces of any salt remaining in the cargo hold. The cargo hold should be absolutely clean and ready for loading grain before the inspector comes on board. To prevent possible condensation in the hold, all the recessed hold adductor systems must be drained of any water residue. They should be clean, dry, odorless. Like I've told you before, the bilge system should also be checked after it has been pumping out water for any remaining of the or any remnants of the grain cargo. When the adductor is empty, the drain plug must be replaced and secured. The adductor hold plate must be secured with the securing bolts, and duct tape should be used to cover both the securing bolts and the recessed lid handles. Hold bilges should be completely dried out, absolutely odorless. There should not be any smell, and in a full operating condition. The surveyor or the grain inspector usually requires to site at least one bilge in each hold to ensure that they have been cleaned out completely and correctly. Tank tops must be completely dry, and any indentations on the tank must be wiped dry. The hold should be completely odorless by maximizing hold ventilation. So make sure your holds are being ventilated throughout the process. Duct tape is used to cover the small gap between the bilge strainer and the tank top. The hold hydrant area should be cleaned and dried out, and the steel cover refitted and secured in place with all its bolts and screws. Prior to the grain inspection, all hatches and access lids must be open and safely secured with all locking pins and bars. All hatches should be checked for loose scale or any kind of paint that is flaking off, that I showed you a picture of in initially in the presentation. If weather conditions permit during the day, the holds should be open to allow fresh air to assist the hold drying process. All small pools of water should be mopped dry. All hatch rubbers and center line seals should be wiped over with a clean dry rag to confirm their cleanliness. You can see in the picture here, this is an example of a hold that is grain clean, that is clean of any previous residues, and it is ready for inspection and loading of cargo in the load port. Finally, hatches not being loaded should be kept closed. All hatches after passing the grain inspection and prior to loading must be inspected on a daily basis to ensure that they are still completely dry and odorless. If required, use ventilation. Chief officer, a senior officer who is specially responsible for loading of cargo or discharging of cargo, should personally ensure that he or she inspects each of these cargo holds before loading commences. And if they are not being used for loading, then on a daily basis, the holds should still be inspected to make sure that the holds are ready for loading grain cargo whenever it reaches the port where the holds will be filled. Hatches containing wheat cargo must not be entered due to a possible lack of oxygen. Like I've said in my previous video, the wheat sometimes, because of the moisture or the vapor that it releases, it absorbs the oxygen from the atmosphere, making it a compartment which is deficient in oxygen, not enough oxygen for breathing of a human. So during the load, it is important to keep the wheat cargo dry. If the wheat is allowed to become wet, then high cargo claims may result in the discharge port. So do not allow the cargo to become wet. Alright, especially if there are any chances of rain happening, make sure you close the hatch covers beforehand. Stop the loading and close the hatch covers. These days, you have your smartphones available. You can check the weather on a daily basis, on an hourly basis. So I'm sure you and together with the cargo superintendent and cargo supervisor will know about the weather or the prevailing weather. Make sure that you do not succumb to commercial pressures, but do not load grain or do not allow the grain cargo loaded to become wet for any reason, because sometimes in discharge ports the shipper may put up a claim if he or she doesn't like the grain cargo that is being received. So regular visual check by ship staff throughout the loading should ensure that the wheat being loaded is not in a wet condition, and these inspections should be recorded in the deck and the cargo logbook. Now, this is also important that not only is your ship dry, not only is your ship ready for loading wheat or grain cargo, but the cargo that is being loaded now from the wharf or the jetty, you should go and inspect that cargo as well. Now, of course, a grain inspector comes in and they take samples of the cargo and test it for any kind of moisture limit or transportable moisture limit. But you as a chief officer or you as a mariner should also go and visually check the cargo, inspect the wharf or jetty, whether the cargo has been kept on a wet jetty, wet premises. And if the cargo is wet, you have the right to refuse to load the cargo, because if you load wet cargo, which may further rot during the voyage, then you are now responsible for discharging this wet cargo. Claims will be against you. So better take precautions and do not load any cargo if you suspect that it is already wet and may lead to further damage. So guys, this was a video today. I just thought I'll make a short video here on preparing the vessel for loading grain and wheat cargo, because this is being asked in the oral examinations these days. Let me know what you thought about this video. I don't want to make it too long. I don't want to go too much into the details. Otherwise, this becomes too long. You have to know enough to be able to answer any questions in the oral examination. So all the best guys, and let me know how I can assist with your exam preparation. I'll be happy to make videos on any topic that you suggest, provided I have time. Bye guys.